I'm here to talk about four things today. Number one, I'm going to talk about the personal challenges that I went through as a triple minority, I like to call it, in the music industry. Number one, I'm a woman. You can't really tell by this picture, right? Because my uniform was overalls, Timberlands, my hair was in a bun. Right, but we encounter a lot of challenges in the music industry as women. You know, it's a male-dominated industry. Secondly, how many of you guys are Filipino? Amazing. Just like when I went to TFC a couple of days ago, I was so proud to walk through the entire office and all the executives were Filipino. I was like, wow, I've never seen this before. It's great to see an audience full of Filipinos. How awesome is it to be Filipino? Right? Oh yeah, cheers for that. And reason being, because we're a mix of cultures, right? We can talk to anybody. We're island people. But it's not always the easiest thing to be one of the only Filipinos in the room in the music industry. I'm going to briefly talk about that. And lastly, some of you women in here, especially Filipino women, I'm vertically challenged. I stopped growing at fourth grade. I'm 4'11". It's okay to break the mold. It's okay to be different. Justin Bieber said it, we have to love ourselves, right? Who would you rather be in here? Would you rather be like everybody else, or would you rather be the yellow one in the middle? On the weekends, I was going to all the hip-hop clubs and watching all the different shows. I was collecting vinyl. I was reading all the magazines, and I was watching BET and MTV religiously. And somehow, because my career was here and my passion was here, I wasn't necessarily happy. And some of you guys might be going through this right now, but it's okay, because you can overcome it. Working hard at internships and volunteering always got me to the next step in my career. At my internships, I was the first one there, I was the last one to leave. I was like, what do I gotta do for you? Get a cup of coffee, gotta run to the store. I'll do anything with the time that I'm here, because I wanna learn everything. To the point that my bosses felt bad when the internship was over. They're like, I'm sorry, we can't hire you, but I'm gonna call my friend who could potentially hire you. And I learned from that point is that networking and volunteering and internship always led me to my next opportunity. A lot of you guys are gonna graduate college. Thousands of people graduate college every year, but what sticks out and what the number one thing, especially in the music industry, is your relationships. Secondly is your experience. Third is your education or your knowledge. So definitely invest in yourself and take the time to develop relations, not only with your teachers, but your classmates who could potentially network with, because those are the people that are gonna work with you in the future. You have to develop a social currency when it comes to networking. Your relationships, your experiences, that's what's gonna be of value when you talk to somebody. So when you meet somebody, you can actually exchange. You know, there's some people that will help you out. There's some people that will, you know, in the goodness of their heart, help you, but eventually that will wear thin. You have to have something of value. Own your ideas, not just your paycheck. And this matters wherever you work. It could be Burger King, it could be a Fortune 500 company. A lot of the times we work somewhere, like I worked at the Athlete's Foot in the West Covina Mall. And people said, you're just doing that for a paycheck, right? I said, yeah, but every week I'm playing Yo MTV Raps behind me and all these artists are coming in to see the new episodes or the old episodes. So on your resume, for people to look at, it's important to show the value that you brought for the companies that you worked for. It's important to own those ideas, not only financially, but for yourself. Social media is an extension of your resume. And I'm not talking about the things you shouldn't post, because none of you guys post inappropriate stuff on your social media, right? No, I'm talking about if you're a guitarist, you better have a video of you playing guitar. If you're a DJ, you better post on your social media of all the times that you're gonna DJ. If you wanna be a publicist, call out that you're looking for different artists. Your social media can be a catalyst for an online network you can develop across the world. I've seen tons of artists meet each other through online. I saw Far East Movement meet Bruno Mars in his top 8. Lil Wayne put Drake in his top 8. And they actually connected online, so you can do the same.